And now we have an issue for the two of Brad Keselowski. Actually, he took advantage of going through part of the road course.
The right side of that car is heavily, heavily damaged. Looks a lot like the 88's damage. Maybe not quite as bad. I'll give him a brush. The 88 was more of a contact. That was a brush. It looked heavier from the front, but from the side view, it's not quite as bad. You see, now he starts heading up the racetrack, still in the normal gripped area. Then he gets up to the dark area, and he gets loose. His car doesn't go anywhere near straight like the 88. His is the opposite.
He was having trouble well before he got there.
Yeah,
you saw the car moving around.
There's a good job.
It looked like he was catching it down at the bottom of the racetrack, and then when he got up to the sticky stuff, it was less than what he was expecting.
Yeah, I said it was heavily damaged because I saw some marks on the right front tire, and normally you have to smash the fender in to get to it. But if you see right here, look at this.
Wow. What a save.
I didn't know drifting was allowed in NASCAR. Holy moly. But that's, right there, I mean, he never wants it. Look at that.
Wow.
So the only thing, they better just look at their steering components. I think the body and the chassis is fine, but that right front tire itself hit the wall a little bit when he had it corrected. But what a save, because it should have been way more damaged than that.